the directions. That is, the sense of what we call above, below, front, back, this side and that side, like that. The sense of direction. Is it clear?
Yes.
Direction. The front and back, it is only a sense in space. So, he also created, this fellow, he also created the directions. Where from? Shrotrat. Ears. So, he has brought out these things from his, the holes of his ears. That means, there is a strange explanation in the Vedic passages about this. They say, how do you understand the universe around you and its existence? The disciple says, with my eyes. Then the teacher asks, how do your eyes see? He says, because there is sunlight. Then the teacher asks, when the sunlight is not there, then the disciple says, in the moonlight. The teacher asks, when the moonlight is absent, he says, in the light of a lamp. He says, when the lamp is not there, the teacher asks, then he says, it is through sound. That is what he says. When we close our eyes, when there is no light at all, we recognize the existence, another existence, through sun. And also we can know whether it is, the fellow is in front of us or in our back, like that. You see, unless there is this conversation, the author can never make it understandable to us. So he gives us in the form of certain conversations in some places. So he says, sound is light that is more brilliant than the optic light. That is what sound principle. Sound is a light which is more brilliant than the optic light. Because when this is absent, that can function. But this cannot function when the other thing is absent. Suppose when there is no light and there is no sound, the eyes cannot blink and function. But the ears can function when there is sound and no light. Therefore, he says, sound is greater light. Here he means the eternal principle of the ear is there in the Purusha. And from it, we have the sense of direction. And from it, our capacity to know the direction through the ear. That is what we call the directional sense. That is the next step. So, this is Shrotra. That is the directions. The devas prepared the directions with the ears of the Purusha. Tatha means in the same way. That means, we have given some examples of how these things periodically come from the eternal principles and the existences come from the periodical principles. We have given the ladder of three steps. That is, the eternal principles, the periodical principles that come down, and then the existences that function. Now you take these examples and you imagine all other things in this creation. That is what he says. In the same way means you work out other things for yourself. Because if he has to work out everything, he has to work out the whole creation and every atom he has to work out. Tatha lokan. Lokan means the planes, that is the planes of existence. The planes. For example, the physical plane, the astral plane, the mental plane, the buddhic plane, the nirvanic, paranirvanic, and mahaparanirvanic. Like this, we have planes of creation. And also, every plane has its 7 sub-planes. And we have the intermediate planes called the states of consciousness. For example, if you are reading in the room, sitting, I am sleeping in the same room, we are said to exist in the same place but in 2 planes. Like that. And if a third person is dreaming, he is in a 3rd plane. One is in sleep, one is in dream, and one is reading the book. So, in the same room, 3 people are in 3 planes. You see? So, there are many thousands and thousands of intermediate planes. All these planes, tatha, in the same way, all these planes, akalpayanna, the last word. Akalpayan, that is, they have created. They have created. In the same way, they have created all these planes. Who? The devas. You see? So the devas woke up from himself and they felt like working. They found the tools of working, they began to work, and they burnt him and distributed the matter of himself in all directions, made an all offering of him. And then there was the sprinkled matter of the same fellow again. They once again gathered, and with it they began to work out the whole universe. This is how it is described till now. And the correspondences of the 3 steps, the eternal principles and the periodical principles who come and go, and the local workings of the existences individual. This is how he has given, and there are, up to this, it is called one section of the hymn completed. There are 2 sections in this. That means, we can understand the whole hymn as 2 halves. Up to this, it is 1 half. And from this, the other half is, it gives us the keys for us to live in him and live as himself. And the art of what we call meditation and God life lived by man. That is the other section. That's why from here, the meter changes. Up to this, it is the same meter which we set 32 syllables, that is 4 lines of 8 syllables each. Every time the meter will be changed when the topic is changed. The translation of the remaining stanzas is also roughly given in your sheet that's given. That forms the total. And I think this is the last class we are having. And I will, if you permit me, I will explain the first stanza of the next section as an example of how to reach God in this. Or if you can read to yourself, I will prepare a complete book of all those things and send you. Whichever. If you permit me to explain the next tense, huh? I'll do it. Do you?
Yes.
Yes.
So, you are not too tired. So here is a key to open the door between the man and the person about whom it is described, God. The doorway being the creator. Man is the created, who is in creation, and the doorway is the creator, and the background of both is the Purusha about whom this is given. So by creator we should not understand God. Creator is a deputy of God who is periodical. According to the Veda, creator is periodical. Along with his creation, he comes down.
Then we can call the second part of this hymn creator?
Yes. So the stanza goes like this. The first line, Vedaham Edam Purusham Mahantam. This contains more syllables. This the meter is changed. According to Sanskrit, I will tell you, 11 syllables in each line.
How many lines?
Four.
Yes. That's it stays.
Yes, except the Gayatri, which has three, every other meter has four lines. This is called Trishtav, that means 11 syllables in four lines. Each line, 11 syllables. Aditya, Varnam, Tamasastu, Pare, Sarvani. Instead of N, you have to utter it as N. Sarvani, not Sarvani. That's why I put the intonation mark. Rupani, Vichitya, Dhiraha, Namani, Kritva, Abhivadan Yat Asate. Vedaham Yetam Purusham Mahantam Aditya Varnam Tamasastu Pare Sarvani Rupani Vichitya Dhiraha Namani Kritva Abhivadan Yad Aste. Here you have to divide into two words, Veda, Aham. Aham means I am. Veda means knowing. The whole thing means I am knowing. I know. Yetam means this fellow, this man, Purusham. Whom we call Purusha. It is the accusative case of the Purusha. Him, Purusha. I know this fellow, this Purusha. See? Mahantam. That is the big one. The big one.
This the name root as Mahatma.
Ah, Mahatma means the big, great soul, big soul. Mahantam means the big one. So this first line indicates, I know this Purusha, the big one. Aditya Varnam. This is a bit troublesome word which should be carefully understood.
It is troublesome.
Unless there is some notes or explanation, the exact import cannot be known. Aditya means son of a wonderful lady called Aditi. You see, there was one lady, Aditi. She was there before this fellow was born. See, wonderful lady. Before the eternal existence was born, she was there. because she could cast his horoscope.
That means, Aditi means what we call the deep. What in Greek called chaos.
You see, in the Greek cosmology you have three fellows. One is the lady called chaos, who is dark, whose bottom cannot be known. The bottomless, that means the void. No bottom.
In the chaos,
and you have another deva in Greek mythology, who is called Theos. That is her son, who is the first light. That is the I am as the born son of that lady. And then a product you have cosmos. That is one unit creation. This is according to the Greek cosmology. That is the Greek scriptures. You find these three fellows. Even then, the oldest fellow Theas, who is equal to our Purusha in his second stage, has a lady who was there existing before him.
Lady Chaos. I know her.
Pardon?
Je la connais. I know her.
Yes.
Lady Chaos.
Yes. So, this fellow is the son of that lady called the deep, or what we say, the darkness.
The darkness.
What do you find in the opening lines of the Genesis, Old Testament? Darkness filled the deep. That means there was no one, including God. It's not correct. There is a peculiar key which we have to hold in our hands. There is no one to exist, that's all. But there is the existence. Here also it is taught through conversations between the guru and disciple. The disciple asks, what was there before creation? The guru says, everything was there as it is now. And the disciple asks, how was it existing? And the guru asks, to whom? That is, creation means the objectification of the observer. The observed thing, the one thing is already there, eternal. But the one who comes out becomes the observer of what is called creation. Therefore, if we question how was the creation, then the guru asks, to whom? Then it solves the problem, really. So, the son of Aditi, that is the mother, she is called the mother of lights.
Mother of light?
Yes. The mother of lights.
Lights.
Plural. Because all the other devas after this fellow awakens, they all come from the background or the mother. So, Aditya means the son of the deep. Varna means Varnam, the word Varnam. Color. Karnam. Yes, Varnam. And also means sound. See, a unit of light and a unit of sound. Both are represented by the same word. He has the color of the son of the deep. That is the meaning. And also he has the sound of the, or the voice of the son of the deep. It's a very complicated symbolism. The total put together is explained in the same scripture in another mantra as the syllable of utterance. The syllable of utterance.
Utterance.
Utterance. Utterance. That is, the same thing comes out as light in one dimension and sound in another dimension, but originally it was one. You see? So, here Aditya Varna means the fellow, the Purusha, having the color or the light of the sun of the bee, and also having the sound, that is the syllable or the name, the sun of the deep. Of course, I send you the notes also, but this is in short what it is. He is shining, that is, he is shining through sound and he is shining through light. Color means light, colors. That's why he is the son of darkness. How can light shine only on the background of what we call darkness? Without darkness, can there be light? Suppose everything is light, there is nothing to see unless there is darkness and light interspersed. So darkness is called in the Rig Veda the background light, in which no observer was present. That is the definition of darkness. The background light in which no observer was present. Blavatsky calls it the total subjectivity. The total subjectivity. And the first stimulation or the first disturbance from it, Blavatsky calls the semi-subjective slumber. The semi-subjective slumber, that is, half of it has become objective, or the fellow is waking up. One fellow is getting his differentiation from it. You see, many people try to explain it in language. Sri Aurobindo in his Savitri calls the deep or the mother by the word the fathomless zero. Fathomless zero. And in her womb, the fellow made his first star of existence. That is how he says. Now, next one. Tamasastupa. Two words. Tamasaha means to the darkness. Tu means what we call an exclamation mark. That's all. Oh. Oh. Pare means. Pare means on the shore, on the shore, sea shore or river shore, you see, shore, on the shore. So, beyond darkness, if we have a shore, here is the observer, who observes that Purusha, beyond darkness and on the shore, you see, one fellow is saying, I know this Purusha. Here, who is the biggest, the big one, and who is the son of the deep or darkness, and who is beyond darkness and on the shore. That is, darkness is like an ocean, and you have to see the fellow on the shore. Shore. Here, according to the scriptures, this darkness is what we call objectivity. We see everything as something different from us. That is called darkness. So you have to reach the other shore from this darkness. Then there is that fellow shining. That means, as long as the seer and the object of seeing are two or different, this fellow cannot be seen. It is all darkness. What we see is only length, breadth, thickness, time, space, everything, except the content of the whole thing, which is called that fellow, wonderful fellow, Purusha. He is not seen. It is all darkness. So he is the son of the darkness. beyond darkness of the objectivity. And there he is standing. When you begin to observe, what is he doing? Sarvani means all. The word, first word of the third line, Sarvani means all. Rupani, the second word, means forms, that is shapes. Rupani. Then the third word, Vichitya. Vichitya means gathering. You see, when you can cross the darkness of objectivity and look to the other shore, the fellow is there shining, very busy always, gathering forms. All forms he is gathering there. He is just playing with his forms, you see. And here is another word, Thiraha. It is also a very significant word. The meaning is the stable one. He is stable there. Suppose you have seen him now. Suppose after 10 years, once again you are reminded, you see he is there still. That means the eternal one. The stable one means the eternal. And also this word means the meditatable one. That's the meaning. About him, you can see only through a process called meditation. You can meditate him, you cannot see him through the senses or mind. So the word Thiraha has a double meaning. One is the stable, the eternal one. He is always there whenever you see. You may come and go, men may come and men may go, but I go on forever, he says. Just like the river. In the evening, sometimes we go to the river, it is there. We come home, we do our work, next evening we go there, it is there. Like that, on the other shore, you will see the fellow twinkling and sparkling whenever you want to see him. And you can see him only as the meditatable fellow. He is busy meditating his own forms. He is doing some other things also, not only forms. Namani means names. Yes, he is doing it. Names. The next one, Krutva. Having made. See, he prepares names also. He prepares forms and calls every form by a name. Names. And then Abhivadan. These echoing the names. That is, he is preparing name, preparing a form, echo. He says to every form, he looks and smiles and says, I am. And that form says, I am. You know echo?
Echo.
Yes, yes. That is when you go and stand before two mountains in a valley, before a valley.
Yes, yeah. I know it.
If you say, hello Rudolph, then there will be the big one who says, hello Rudolph. So this fellow is playing that game wonderfully. Abhivadan, that is, he is uttering I am, and each form is uttering I am. That is what he plays. Yatta, next. Since. That means, since he is doing all these things. It's only a relative pronoun, it's a conjunction used. And finally, the word Aste. He is there. Aste means is there.
He is there.
In our sentence is there. Aste is he is there. In a third person. He or she, whatever you can use. So here, the whole thing means I know this fellow who is there busy in creating forms and busy in preparing names and making the echo of each name. That means we have in us his echo in the form of the I am, and also we know things by names. You see once again in the book of Proverbs, God named everything with name. And in the Genesis, towards the end of the first chapter, He made man, and God made man see everything, and man named everything, and God fixed it as its name. You see, in the first chapter, towards the ending, the 24th verse, it is a stanza of the book of Genesis, first chapter. He has shown the man, Adam, He created out of dust and said, see all this. And the man saw, there was a bull. Man saw and said, bull. There was dog. He said, dog. God said, yes, dog. Yes, bull. That is, He fixed it up. That means not in English or in any other language, but He gave the fellow an expression, and the man named everything with a name, and he began to know things by names. Like that. So, I know that Purusha, who is the big, that means the concept of big is there, but he is always bigger than the concept of big. So he is the big one, he is there. I know him only as the son of the deep or darkness. And only towards the other shores beyond darkness. Because if I see anyone else except himself, it is darkness. It is what we call